Thank you very much, Diederik. I would like to share a narrative of Amsterdam explaining the connection of water heritage to the functionality of the system, and by the functionality of the system also to the future of our place in the Delta. Let me see if it works. Yes. Actually, the water system forms the Venice system of the landscape, because it's lying below sea level, and it's essential for functioning. The best way of protection of the world's water heritage is by using it. A lot of the old structures that were very functional over the past centuries are still functional or partly functional, and some are not anymore, but they have got another use. And the second best way to protect them is by reusing them in another way. And I want to explain this to you. When we look at the place of Amsterdam, this is on a map in the Netherlands, we see there is a branch connecting the big river, one of the branches of the Rhine, to the North Sea by IJmuiden. And the entire green area is the surplus of rainwater is drained, is spilled to the North Sea by IJmuiden. And it's also when at normal circumstances, part of the base flow of River Rhine flows through this branch in river of River Rhine. And what we see is that we have, when this system is not functioning, we have an alternative with another pumping station with the red arrow. I want to explain more about this. When we look at the water levels in our system, we have this primary channel system draining the water to the sea, and we have all polders with different levels, some of them even 6 meters below sea level. And all of these water levels are maintained very exactly around, let's say, 5 or 10 centimeters. So we have a very strict water level management supporting the use of our land, being cities or agricultural land. Now, when we go back in the history, this is a map of 1749. We see that Amsterdam, when I enlarge the map, is lying on a branch of the sea, actually, with a tidal action. And now when we go into the city, we are looking at an image around 1700. And there is a dike here in the red line, a levee, protecting the city for this tidal area outside of the city. And when we zoom into this, we can see that there are many sluices, openings for transport through this dike. This is an image of out of this picture, in which we can see that there was turbid water outside, and it has flood level and ebb tide level. And the doors of Amsterdam were closed because preventing the water of outside to enter the city. And then in 1872, there was a new channel dug from Amsterdam to the North Sea. And the tide was taken out by building a big lock system in 1872, just east of the city. Now, when we go to the same place of this canal, and we see that there's very quiet water, it seems that this water is standing, but actually it isn't. Always the water level seems to be the same, but it's the effect of 24/7 water management. When there's too much, it's spilled. When there's lack of water, there is an inlet. So this is 24/7 water level management. It seems like standing water, but it isn't. It's a very dynamical system. It's shown here. This is an actual other point in this levee, another sluice. We see that there is a channel which is also inspected because it's still functional. And this channel actually is 400 years or old. When we look at the map, it connects two canals south and north of this square. And actually the red line indicates that the channel is going under this ancient building 1488 of the Waag at the Nieuwmarkt in Amsterdam. We did an inspection of this 2 weeks ago. So I have these pictures of this inspection. It's very interesting when you see this, and no one ever comes there ever unless it's for an inspection. We can see that it's still functional. It has been maintained over 400 years because it is functional. At the lower part of this slide, you see that there is even a sluice. There are doors that can be closed when there would be high water level outside. So now we look again back to this map of 1700, and at the yellow dot, this was the place where we did this inspection. When we look at all these dots are structures of water heritage. The blue ones are not functional anymore, and the red ones are still functional. And the point I want to make here is that the functional system, of course, I will show more why it's still functional, and the blue ones are still recognizable in the city, and they are maintained, maybe places to sit at the water, but they show us the old system, which was very needed when Amsterdam was still flushed using tidal action. So there are several points where you can recognize the old structure. What we did between, let's say, 17th century and the end of the 19th century, water was entered in the city at a high tidal level, and then led through the city to flush and improve water quality. And we see the fresh or the clean blue water changing into red contaminated water in the flushing system. So actually at the yellow dot, you can see that this inspection door, it was functional in 1700 and until 1872. Now this is a current map, and this place is still functional, and it will become more functional even in future. Nowadays, when a river, when the big branch connecting a river Rhine to IJmuiden would not be functioning, we could close all these doors, these ancient doors, and use a pumping station in the city of Amsterdam itself to keep the city dry. So these old doors that were used by in water management all the time, letting the river water go to the sea and at another moment prevent the city from flooding from outside water, are still functional when we want to close them and give an alternative way to keep Amsterdam dry. And in future, we will have sea level rise. This is a picture looking into 2300, and the sea level rise, which could be 1 meter, but probably also 2 to 5 meters, this system will become more functional. So the point I want to make is that the assets are connected to values of water, water safety, water level management, water quality management even. The assets represent an economic value. Huh? We maintain them and we still have need for them. So we maintain them and we invest. They are not only the physical objects, they are also the intangible values. Concepts, political structures, and they represent also the spiritual identity of this area, which is lying below the sea level. They are an essential part of our living environment nowadays, but especially in future when sea level will come and be an enhanced hazard for a low-lying city as Amsterdam. The assets, they connect the landscape and the water in the landscape to people living and working in this area. And the point I want to make is that water heritage, when has a functional part, it's essential for our area. It will be essential in future, and connecting also the identity of the people to the awareness of the functionality of the water system. And the old systems are shown in the city and are very much important for this identity and the common idea that we should invest in maintaining our living environment and have a good quality of it. So this was during the inspection, and I would like to thank you for your attention.